Hey, this is Paul from Wondershare MobileTrans, and welcome back to another video. And today, we're going to talk about one of these topics that crops up for people every single day. And of course, that is talking about WhatsApp backup. And a lot of people want to know how you can do that on iOS 15. And sometimes things change and you never know where to find the right options. So today's video is all about how you can backup your WhatsApp in iOS 15. But before we get into all of that video, if you're new to the MobileTrans channel, then you want to subscribe to it so you don't miss any of the videos. And of course, if you want to know something or need help with something, leave a comment down below and we will get back to you. But let's get into today's video. When iOS 15 was released a couple of weeks ago, a lot of people upgraded to it, and a lot of people faced an issue where they couldn't actually find their WhatsApp chat history or backups anymore. And if you think you're alone with that problem, then you're not, because I faced it, loads of other people have faced it all around the world, so it is not just you. But if you can't retrieve those backups of your WhatsApp, then unfortunately, they are going to be lost forever. The first method in today's video is to show you how you can make sure you keep those WhatsApp chats backed up by using iCloud. iCloud is one of the built-in features on iPhone, and you can back up several kinds of information from your device to iCloud if you have an account, which this means you can back up data from apps including WhatsApp on iCloud, and usually the backup process runs automatically in the background. But first, you actually need to be able to enable that for it to work. So let me show you these really easy methods and steps on how you can do it. Firstly, you need to launch the settings from your iPhone's home screen. And then at the top, you will see your Apple ID. So tap on that. Now tap iCloud to access the different settings for syncing your iCloud account to your device. Then just enable iCloud by tapping on the toggle beside the iCloud drive, and also ensure that you have also enabled the iCloud backup. And finally, keep scrolling down to locate the WhatsApp setting under iCloud and tap the toggle button beside it to make sure that this is then enabled. And that is that. That is how simple it is to make sure your WhatsApp chats are backed up via iCloud. But there is sometimes a problem with iCloud, and one of them being that you only get 5 gigs of free space that Apple give you. So if you need more space, you're gonna have to buy it. And you can't selectively then choose the chats that you wanna back up or even restore. So sometimes iCloud is not the best option, but method 2 might be the better option for you. If you've ever used WhatsApp before in your life, then you probably know that WhatsApp itself allows you to make sure you can back up your chats directly within the app, and then you can restore them once you get a new phone, if it's an iPhone, and take all of those chats over with you. And there's a couple of ways that you can do it. You can either have this be done automatically every single day, or weekly, or monthly, it's up to you, or you can actually do it manually yourself. So let me show you exactly what you need to do to get that to work. Make sure you open up WhatsApp first of all, and then go into the settings menu at the bottom right of the WhatsApp screen. Then tap on chats on the settings page. And then finally, you can just tap chat backup on the next page. And then once that opens, you'll see how to backup your WhatsApp data. You can do this manually and tap backup now. And you can also tap on auto backup to decide how frequently WhatsApp backs up your data. Like I said, it could be daily, weekly, or monthly. And at times this is a bit annoying because WhatsApp will take forever to make sure that that backup is happening. So the best thing to do is just make sure your app is up to date, or if that doesn't work, then follow these next steps. Delete WhatsApp data from your iCloud account. So launch the settings on your device, select iCloud and tap on manage storage, and then just select WhatsApp Messenger. And then just tap delete data. And then for the third step, just make sure you disable the iCloud and force close settings, and then launch WhatsApp. Close WhatsApp and return to settings and enable iCloud. You can now use the steps that we discussed a minute ago to create a new WhatsApp backup. But we have another method for you as well, and that is to keep your files and WhatsApp data all saved locally in our next method. If using a cloud service is not what you want to do, and sometimes that is the best option, we have a really good option for you where you can save all of your WhatsApp backups on iOS 15 locally, and that is an app called MobileTrans. With MobileTrans, you can safely and swiftly backup your chats with your photos, group data, videos, documents, and other WhatsApp-related resources with MobileTrans WhatsApp Transfer. And here are the benefits to show how efficient this software is it actually creates a backup of WhatsApp chats and other related resources like we just mentioned, with videos, photos and attachments to your PC. Not only that, if you get an Android phone and want to transfer your chats from your iPhone to that Android phone, then MobileTrans can help with that as well. And as well as all that, it is quick, it is easy and it is really simple to do. So let me show you the methods and what you'll need to do to get those WhatsApp chats on iOS 15 backed up with MobileTrans. The first thing you need to do is download the MobileTrans app. And if you haven't done that already, you can do that from the official MobileTrans website. Then connect your iOS device to your PC using a lightning cable and just launch MobileTrans. The next thing you'll need to do is select WhatsApp. This is the action that will make the app detect your device automatically and display all the types of data available for backup. The backup data includes photos, messages, audios, and other bits of data. And once you click on start, you'll then start to back up all of the types of WhatsApp data, but you can't actually select this type of data. Just make sure that you don't disconnect the device as well before that transfer is complete. Otherwise, you'll have to start it again. And once it is then completed, you will get a message to notify you that the process is complete. Anytime you then want to access that data, you can do with your PC. And if you want to transfer again, like I said before, over from iPhone to Android, your PC and MobileTrans has all of this data there ready for you, waiting to go. The earlier methods that we showed you are really good for people that have lots of data which they want to make sure is transferred over. But what if you have a couple of chats that you just want to transfer the data of? You might be asking, well, is there a way that I can do that? And yes, there is a way that you can do that. You can actually make sure that your chats are backed up on iOS 15 using WhatsApp with Google Drive. And then you're like, well, how do I use Google Drive to do that? Well, it's nice and easy and simple, because what happens is that WhatsApp give you the option to actually email the chats to yourself as a form of a WhatsApp backup. Google Drive gives you 15 gigabytes of free cloud storage, which means that what you can do is save your chats when you've emailed them to yourself in your Google Drive. But this is an option where you can then not restore those chats. It just means you have your important chats saved there forever. So let me show you how you can do it. Launch WhatsApp and open the conversation that you need to save. This conversation can be a group or individual chat. Second of all, tap on the conversation icon and check more options and select email chat. Your action in step two presents you with a list of options, including or excluding attachments of your chat. Most email servers though have a limit, and for Google it's 25 megabytes. So just make sure here you don't include those large files. You can then just choose your preferred email app, and this can be anything, but for this one we're going to choose Google, and then you will see a draft window with a TXT file attachment. This attachment is your backup file and you can simply send this to yourself on email. However, there are a few pros and cons for these methods. Let's start with the pros, first of all, and the first one is that it is actually free, so you can't go wrong with that. And then the second one is that you can then access this chat on any device that you can log into your email with. But when there are pros, there are also cons. It's a bit complicated for someone who wants to just save a single chat, and it can take forever. And that is the second con, that it is just really time consuming. And of course, the third con is that actually this is not a place where you can then restore your chat. It is just for you to keep hold of and read. And when you do read it, it sometimes doesn't look fantastic. There we go. There are all the methods that you can use to back up your WhatsApp on iOS 15. Some of them are cloud-based, and of course, some of them are local-based using your PC. Just like MobileTrans, and that for me is probably the best option, because it takes no time at all, it's done in just a couple of clicks, and then that means you have all of your files locally and can even move them from your iPhone backup over to an Android backup. If this video helped you, then why not give it a like? And of course, if you need help with anything, let us know in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as we can, and hopefully make a video on a topic that you might be stuck with. And of course, why not subscribe to the MobileTrans channel as well? And if you do all of that, then we will see you in the next video.